गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू केमिस्ट्री क्लास। चिल्ड्रन, इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 3, एलिमेंट कंपाउंड एंड मिक्सचर। इन दैट वी हैव सीन हाउ द मैटर इज क्लासिफाइड अमंग प्योर सब्सटेंस एंड मिक्सचर, हाउ द मैटर इज क्लासिफाइड अमंग प्योर एंड मिक्सचर। देन वी हैव सीन दैट प्योर सब्सटेंस इज अगेन क्लासिफाइड अमंग एलिमेंट एंड कंपाउंड, वेयर then element is again classified in between 4 types: metal, non-metal, metalloid and noble gas. So continuing with that same point, yesterday or in the last lecture I have explained about the pure substance, and in that the first one, that is element. When I have tell you about the element, we have discussed about metal and its characteristics. Its characteristics. While explaining the characteristics of metal, I have told you that metals are good conductor of heat and light. Then they are sonorous. They have luster. They have high density. They are malleable, they are ductile in nature. What do you mean by malleability? That I have told you. What do you mean by ductility? That I have told you. Then they are solid at room temperature, they are hard. All these things we have already discussed. But we know that each and everywhere, after that I have told you some examples also. As I have told you all these characteristics of metal, but keep in mind that there is exception for each and everything. Okay, in the same way here also for the metals, there are some exceptions. For example, I have told you they are solid at room temperature. Solid at room temperature. Metals are solid at room temperature. But there is an exception with the mercury and with the gallium. Mercury and gallium, they are liquid at room temperature. Other than that, all the metals, they are solid at room temperature. After that, I told you all the metals are hard, but except sodium and potassium, all the metals were hard. Then I have told you they are malleable, they are ductile, but no, except with the zinc, other all metals were malleable and ductile. Then I have told you they are good conductor of heat and light. No, tungsten is the metal. Tungsten is the metal which is bad conductor of heat and light. So in this way, characteristics of metals we have finished. Now the next point is non-metal. Non-metal and what properties they will show. See, the element which having 5, 6 or 7 electrons in their valence shell, it is called as non-metal. 5, 6 and 7 electrons in their valence shell, they are called as a non-metal. Now the characteristics of non-metal, let us see that. Keep in mind, all the properties of metal, opposite to that, the properties of non-metals are there. Characteristics of non-metals are as follows. The first characteristic is that non-metals were bad conductor of heat and light. Non-metals were bad conductor of heat and light. They are non-sonorous. Non-sonorous means they will never produce a sweet and melodious sound. Then they don't have luster. Luster means chamak. They don't have any type of luster. After that, they have low density. as compared to metal. Non-metals have low density. They are non-malleable. Non-malleable, they are non-ductile. Non-malleable means after hammering, we can't convert them into sheet, and non-ductile means after hammering, we can't draw a wire from that. Then, non-metals were liquid, non-metals are liquid and gaseous at room temperature, and they are soft. Generally, the non-metals were soft. For example, if you want to say examples of non-metal, carbon, sulfur, iodine, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, all are the example of non-metals. So here we have finished metal and non-metal. As we know that in metals there are some exceptions, in the same way non-metals also have some exceptions with the characteristics. Let us see that. Just now I told you the non-metals, they don't have luster, but graphite is the non-metal which possess luster. As you have seen in your pencil, the lead of the pencil is made up of graphite, and because of the luster only it is used in the pencil to write anything. After that, graphite is also a good conductor of heat and light. Then iodine is also there, which also having luster. Bromine is liquid at room temperature. Continuing with the same, after metal, non-metal, now the next point is metalloid. The element which show property of metal as well as non-metal, that is called as a metalloid. Just now we have seen properties of metal also, properties of non-metal, characteristics of metal, characteristics of non-metal. In the same way, I have told you the definition of metalloid, that the elements which shows the properties of metal as well as non-metal are called as metalloid. For example, arsenic, germanium, antimony, all are the metalloid which shows or which possesses the property of metal as well as non-metal. And the last point, that is a noble gas. Noble gases. As we know that in our periodic table or in our universe or in the world, there are 118 or 20 elements were there. Few are metal, few are non-metal, few are metalloids, and the remaining one are the noble gases, which are stable in the universe. They will never react. They are always be stable. They don't want to react with any other element. Now let us see the characteristics of noble gas. First, they are gaseous in nature. Another point is they are chemically less reactive. Just now I told you chemically less reactive. As the name indicates, noble means we are generally telling that this is a noble man, this is a noble boy, means they are always keep, they are be humble, polite, and that's why they called as a noble. So noble gases are chemically less active. As they are less reactive, they are available in a free state in nature. And they exist monoatomic in nature. For example, neon, argon, krypton are the example of noble gases. So today we will stop here only. In the next lecture, we will take the next point, compound. Till then, children, good day.